So in this module, we're going to look at a couple tools or tips for equilibrium calculations. Really, it's basically just one with a couple of varieties. So we're going to start out with an example that looks probably maybe a little familiar to you. So we have this equilibrium here. This molecule dissociating into two molecules of nitrogen monoxide and a molecule of chlorine. And equilibrium constant is 1.6 times 10 to the minus 5th at 35 Celsius. So let's say we start out with this many grams of nitrogen monoxide, this many grams of chlorine, in a 0.2500 liter container, 250 mils, at this temperature. What will the equilibrium concentrations of all species present at equilibrium be? Well, one thing that when we first look at this is a pretty small equilibrium constant. I mean, you know, you'll see it's a lot smaller. 10 to the minus 30th, 10 to the minus 50th, but still, that's significantly smaller than 0.001. So what that means is that at equilibrium, there's going to be very little of these present, and mostly this. But see, we're starting in this problem with this and this, the products, this way this is written. So one of the tips, one of the ways of getting around that is to say, okay, let's reverse this reaction, see what happens. And then, okay, so because we reversed the reaction, we took 1 over K to get the K for this, for the reaction written this way, and now that's a pretty big number. Now what we're gonna say is, all right, well, the way we do this, the next kind of tool is to say, because this K is so big, we're going to figure out our initial concentrations of these reactants, the nitrogen monoxide and the chlorine, and say, let them all react. Let's say they just totally react and we make product, and then we start from there and go backwards. Watch. So, okay, we're going to start by calculating our concentrations of our nitrogen monoxide and chlorine initially. We get these two numbers here. Now, okay, again, because K is so large, we're going to say basically we make this many moles per liter of nitrogen, of this product right here. So the idea is, the way this was set up, the way I set these numbers up, is we have pretty much twice the number of moles of this as we have chlorine, right? And so it doesn't really matter what you use as the limiting reactant, because they both will be used up. So 2 moles of these make 1 mole of this, or 1 mole of this makes 2 moles of this. Either way, we get about 0.0057 or so moles per liter of our product initially. You see that? So we're saying it all reacts, and this is how much we have of our, what it was, our product. Now we flip it back around, and we say we're going to let this decompose and make our products. Now our K once more is 1.6 times 10 to the minus 5th. And we start out, okay, set up, now we set up our ice table. Initially we have this much of this, 0 and 0, minus 2 because of this 2, minus 2x because of this 2, plus 2x. There's a 1 here, so just plus x. And at equilibrium, we have these amounts. Now we're gonna plug into the equilibrium constant expression with our x's. Now, if you look at this, this is going to be a cubic equation. If we rearrange this and set it up to solve for x, it's a cubic equation, which, you know, we can solve, but it's somewhat tedious, and we really don't want to do that by hand if we don't want to. So this is the next kind of tip or tool. Let's say, because k is so small, let's try an approximation. Let's say this term here is a lot smaller than this term here. Let's say that 2x is a lot smaller than 0.2057. If that's true, that makes our life a lot easier, because, right, if we neglect the 2x down here, now not up here, no, because it's not being subtracted from something, just down here, we get an expression that looks like this. Now this we can solve. We just multiply through by 2.2057 squared, divide by 4, and take the cube root. If you do that, check my work, make sure you get the same answer. Get x is about 0.0055 or so. There's 2 other roots because it's a cubic, but they're both imaginary. So we don't take imaginary roots. We don't use those. They don't make sense. So now let's check. Okay, here's the 5% rule, another kind of tip. When we're neglecting a term in our equation, if that term is less than about 5% of the term we're comparing it to. So in this case, if 2x is less than or equal to about 5% of 0.2057, we'll call that a good approximation. So let's check. So x was 0.0055 or so. Compare that to 0.2057. So 2 times that divided by 0.2057 times 100 to get 5.4%. That's about 5%. So we'll call that good. Any much bigger than that though, and that would not be a good approximation. And we'd have to, you know, bite the bullet and solve the cubic equation, which is kind of fun, but might take a little longer. All right, so now that we know x, we can find the equilibrium concentrations of all our species. So remember, nitrogen monoxide was 2x, so that's this. Chlorine is just x, so it's this. And our nitrosyl chloride, I think this is going to be 0.2057 minus 2x, which is about 0.195 more. Another check, okay, we can do is we can plug back into our equilibrium constant expression. Our equilibrium concentrations for nitrogen monoxide, chlorine, and so forth, we plug these guys in, and we get, well, 1.75 times 10 to the minus 5th, which is pretty close to 1.6 times 10 to the minus 5th. The reason it's not right at 1.6 times 10 to the minus 5th is that approximation. We were kind of on the border. We were pushing a little bit, but it was close to 5%, so we called it good.